Hello everybody, good afternoon, Invisible Ray here, and after all the controversy yesterday, you know, there was a lot of upset people because of my video upload. So, just to prove that I love McCartney, you know, not as much as John, but I do, and I want to speak about an album which I thoroughly enjoyed, and I can tell you now it's going to get a 10 out of 10.
Yeah, just altogether pointless.
It is possibly the compilation album that works the best out of all the Beatles. I mean, I don't even think there's been a compilation that works as well from John, but this one was perfect. And today I shall be reviewing...
Who is it?
Wings Greatest. Yep. Now the good thing about this album is it's before things got really complicated. I mean, before Pipes of Peace had to make an appearance. Do I put in Say and Ebony and Ivory? You know, all that sort of stuff. And you know, I mean, it's even more complicated now. Pure McCartney was, it was a mixed bag of the good, the bad, and the bloody ugly. But let me, you know, I'll give you the history about this. Now, I got sent away to technical college when I was 17. I had this on a cassette, and I had my Toshiba player. No TV in them days, you know, it was brutal. And I used to finish the day's work, and I'd just be listening to it on a loop. I'd fall asleep. It was nice, you know, I used to get myself a little can of cheap cider, get on my pit, and I'd just fall asleep, and it'd turn itself over, it'd keep going, and it was brilliant. I loved every single track. Now, there's not many albums, I'm an impatient man, and there's not many albums I can listen to all the way through, but this is one of them. Now, I heard a couple of reviews, and I don't want to mention names, but I might do, and some people was grumbling of all things. Oh, another day. It's not a Wings track. When he was Uncle Albert, I mean, it's so what? So what? I mean, Wings, Paul McCartney. Who gives a fuck? It's the same thing. It's Paul McCartney we're here for. That's what we bought tickets for. Anyway, this person. And I have to mention your name, Mr. Mayo, because you mentioned there was no listen to what the man said. Now, when I had this album, I was upset because they didn't have listen to what the man said. Maybe I'm amazed. And what was the other one? Simu. But I was happy with what I did have. And you know, although it could have done with... I'm not so fussed about Maybe I'm Amazed being on here. But I really wanted Sea Moon rather than High High High, because I much prefer that one. You know, we've listened to what the man said. It's a track, and I'll discuss this in the Venus and Mars, but it's a track that is instantly likeable. You hear it and you think, great. A friend of mine, Lee, come round, heard the record, loved it, went and brought the album, Venus and Mars, directly after you heard it round my drum. And but the thing is with that song, you get bored of it so damn quick. I mean, it's you know, it's an unlucky kind of song, because I know it got to number one in America. I think it got two in the UK as well. But, you know, it's one of them. You get songs like that. You think, yeah, this is great, this song. And then 5 minutes later, you think, oh, I don't want to hear that again. And it's been like that for years. I've never put that song on for years. I haven't listened to it. So it's better with this song not being on here. Anyway, that's that. So, yeah, what we'll do, we'll go through the tracks. Now, some of them will be reviewed on other albums. Some of them have been reviewed on other albums. So bear with me, because there's going to be just a four or five I'm going to speak about in some depth. The rest of them, I'm just going to refer you to the other albums. I shouldn't even have to tell you where to look, but I will do in case there's young people out there who've never heard of Paul McCartney before. You know, it's possible. But anyway, here we go.
Every day she takes a morning bath, she wets her hair, wraps a towel around her as she's heading for the bedroom chair. It's just another day.
It's just another day. Well, this is an early one of Macca's. I think it was his first single when it got to number two in the charts. It's pleasing enough. I mean, you know, if it comes on the radio, I like it. I dig it. I dig it. So it's going to get an 8, not a 10, but it's a good song. I enjoy it. Silly love songs. Well, look on my wings at the speed of sound for that, but I can tell you, the perfect song, the perfect McCartney track.
It's a 10 out of 10.
Live and let die. Well, there we are. I mean, Red Rose Speedway, I've reviewed this on. Check it out, baby. But it gets 8 out of 10. I might give it 7 on the Red Rose Speedway, but I'll adjust that to 8 because it's a good song. It's a good song. Farm. Oh, do you know what? When I used to listen to The Wings Greatest when I first got it, I loved this one. I thought, because I hadn't got it, you know. Totally wrong, but anyway, I really dug it. And then years later, I started thinking about it and thought, no, the lyrics are a bunch of shit. Really stupid lyrics. I mean, it's saved by the instrumentation. It's brilliant, rocking. It's a rocking tune, but I'm going to give it a 5 because it, like I said, the stupid lyrics. We all chip in for a bag of cement. Fuck off. Band on the Run. I mean, 10 out of 10. 10 out of 10. Check the Band on the Run album review, though, because, you know, we'll talk about it in depth. Fabulous song. Maybe the best song he's ever done. We'll go into that in some detail later on, but it is a cracking tune. There is no end to what we can do together. Oh, with a little luck. London Trek Town review for this one. 10 out of 10, though. I mean, it's brilliant. Even though it's such a corny video. I mean, it is so naff. You see all those people, white people that can't dance, and the token black man. Oh, God. It is a shit video. But a great song, and a big number one in America.
It's a 10 out of 10.
We're so sorry, Uncle Albert, but there's no one left at home, and I believe I'm gonna wait.
Okay, well, dealing with Uncle Albert separately to Admiral Halsey. Uncle Albert, I love it. It's a good tune. I'll give that a 9 out of 10. Admiral Halsey is shit, and the lyrics are fucking dreadful, and Linda's backing is awful. This has been explained on RAM. I think I'll give it a 2 or a 3, but we'll go for a 2 because it annoys me.
Garbage! Christmas Day!
Huh?
No!
Gonna get high, high, high. Got to give that a 5. Might give it a 6 on the wildlife review, but check it out. 5 or 6. Out of 10 classic. Wings at the Speed of Sound review. It's been done. Brilliant song.
It's in the hands of my love, and my love does it go.
My love, another 10 out of 10. And another awful video with Macca pulling this awful face. We've got, oh, when the cover's bare. I mean, you check it out. He's nauseating. But what a song. What a song. But Macca, less of your romantic face, because he's side-splitting. It really is. Woo! Check. 10 out of 10. Check the Band on the Run album for that, though.
All of Kintyre, oh, mist rolling in from the sea. My desire is always.
All of Kintyre, monster, a monster of a hit. I mean, this was the biggest selling records in Britain from 1977 till 1984, when Band Aid knocked it off the top spot. However, if you knock away all the charity singles that sold better, this is the highest selling non-charity single still to this day. It's quite an achievement, considering, and quite sadly, nobody under the age of 30 probably even heard of this. But that's the way it goes, you know. I mean, everybody under the age of 30 knows Imagine, though, which is kind of weird, because, I mean, that only got to number one in Britain after John's tragic death. But I bet that fucks Paul off big time. Anyway, it's a simple 3-bar song, but the words are well thought out, and, you know, I mean, sweep through the heather like deer in the glen. Carry me back to the days I'm in. Oh, it's brilliant. I still love it to this day. It's, you know, it was spinning around in our house for ages. It was, I mean, it's great. It's great. I mean, what else can I say about it? Well, for those not in the know, it's Mull of Kintyre's in Scotland. This is where Paul was living at the time, so it's kind of like a homage to his home. Denny Lane wrote it with him, but due to Denny Lane's cocaine problem and girlfriend with cocaine problem, he'd run out of money. Plus, after Wings broke up, the man was broke. Paul cut him a deal, says, I'll tell you what, you don't own the rights to any of the rights to Mull of Kintyre anymore. I bought them off you. And then that was it. So it's a McCartney song. Pure and simple. But I mean, it's brilliant. And it's a great way to finish the album. I wonder, though, you know, because it didn't get anywhere in America, which kind of proves transatlantic music tastes, they rarely meet in the middle, do you know what I mean? It's funny that. So, I wonder what our Yankee cousins were up to at this time.
So many nights I'd sit by my window.
Well, there you have it.